Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 69 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 116 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 117. You have an Azure subscription that contains the resources shown in the following table. The resource name is VNet1, that is a virtual network, that is in resource group 1, VNet2, which is a virtual network, and that is in resource group 2, and one virtual machine, which is VM1, and that resides in resource group 2. The status of VM1 is running. You assign a Azure policy shown in the exhibit. So let's scroll down. The policy details are as follow. We have scope of the policy, which is limited to resource group 2 only. There is no exclusion, and the policy definition is not allowed resource types, and that is assigned by user, and there are three parameters selected which we will scroll down and see in detail. So let's scroll down. First parameter is microsoft.classic network/microsoft networks, so that will be not allowed resource type. Then another one is microsoft.network virtual networks, these are also not allowed. And the third one is microsoft.compute virtual machines, these are not allowed. So these three parameters or three type of resources are not allowed by this policy in resource group 2, and we have to check these statements. So statement 1 is an administrator can move VNet1, which is in the resource group 1, to resource group 2. The second statement is the state of virtual machine 1 change to deallocated. Can we change it or no? We have to check this. And the third statement is an administrator can modify the address space of VNet2. So let's go to Azure portal and check this one by one. We are in Azure portal now. We'll go to resource group. We have created resource group 1. Under the resource group 1, we have created one virtual network, VNet1. And under the resource group 2, RG2, we have created a virtual machine and a virtual network, VNet2. Further, in resource group 2, our virtual machine state must be running, so we can see the state of our virtual machine is running. Now we will be creating a policy for resource group 2. We'll define the policy is mentioned in the question, not allowed resource type. We'll go to next step. We'll go to parameters. The first parameter we will select is virtual network, and that would be the Microsoft Classic Virtual Network. The second parameter would be Microsoft Network/virtual networks. We are under Microsoft Network Virtual Networks. The third parameter would be Microsoft Compute Virtual Machines. Microsoft Compute, and virtual machines. And create. Policy assignment succeeded on resource group 2. Now we will check the first statement, which is an administrator can move VNet 1 to RG2. So we'll go to resource group 1. Under the resource group 1, we do have virtual network 1. And we'll check if we can move the VNet 1 to the resource group 2. So we selected RG2. We tick this and press OK. It would be validating. It might take maybe 1 to 2 minutes, and we'll come back. After a while, we got this error, validation failed. Click here to see the details. So error details are: resource VNet 1 was disallowed by policy. Code request disallowed by policy. So we were unable to move VNet 1 to resource group 2. Let's see next statement, which is the state of VM1 changed to deallocated. So let's go to resource group 2, where our virtual machine 1 is running, and we'll try to stop the virtual machine, and the status will be deallocated. Let's see. Press yes. It may also take some time. So our virtual machine's status is changed to deallocated, means for the second statement it worked. Now let's check the third statement, which is an administrator can modify the address space of VNet 2. So we'll go to virtual network 2, VNet 2. We'll go to address space. Under the address space, we'll change it to 16 and we'll hit save. Here we can see fail to save virtual network change. Fail to save address space change to virtual network VNet 2. Error: resource VNet 2 was disallowed by policy. Policy identifier not allowed resource types. So for the statement number 3, it was not successfully worked. So for statement number 2 only it worked. Let's go back to question. Statement 1, an administrator can move VNet 1 to RG2. We have tested this on Azure portal. We found that virtual network 1 cannot be moved to resource group 2 due to not allowed resource type policies. So answer for the first statement would be no. The second statement, we were successfully able to change the status of virtual machine, therefore this is the yes. For the third statement, an administrator can modify the address space of virtual network 2. We were not able to change the address space of virtual network 2 due to the policy, and definitely that was because of not allowed resource type virtual networks. Therefore, the answer for third statement would be no. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you next video.